Hello everyone, my name is Samuel Francois from the company HORIBA, and today I would like to share with you the 5 things you need to know to do a good pH measurement with a HORIBA pH meter. So the first thing you need to know is that it's important to do a regular calibration. The calibration is a reference point for your pH meter. It can be done from 1 to 5 points, but usually our customer would calibrate their meter in 2 points with the pH 7 and the pH 4 solution. For pH meter, we recommend to do a weekly calibration, but if you measure a lot of sample in one day, you can do a calibration every 20 to 30 measurement. Always remember, the more frequently you will do the calibration, the most accurate your result will be. The second thing you need to know is that it's important to do an electrode conditioning when the meter has been stored for a long time. So in that case, the sensor will be dry, and if you calibrate the meter straight after taking the meter outside the box, you can see a drift after the calibration when you do your first measurement. So to avoid this, we recommend you to put the pH 7 solution on the sensor for about 20 minutes, and then after you can go ahead with the calibration, and you will be sure to have the most accurate calibration you can have. The third thing you need to know about doing a good pH measurement is that it's important to wait the meter stabilization when you do the calibration. So when you do the calibration, the right thing to do is to put first the pH standard solution on the sensor and wait for about 20 seconds for the meter to stabilize. After the stabilization, you can go and calibrate the meter. If you do it the other way around, there is a risk that you get a calibration error, or maybe your calibration will not be accurate because the meter will tend to calibrate too quickly. The first thing you need to know to do a good pH measurement is that on the LAQUA twin pH meter from HORIBA, it's important to put enough pH standard solution. So in the LAQUA twin case, it will be a minimum volume of 0.1 milliliter, but the electrode is made of two parts, the reference electrode and the pH electrode, and you want to make sure that your liquid or your sample or your standard solution is covering the 2 points, and this is very critical for the sensor to read a good signal, okay? And finally, the cleaning, maintenance, and storage is important. So first, for the cleaning, we recommend you to do a cleaning after every measurement. For this, you can use water. Tap water is okay, and deionized water is better. In case you do a measurement with a greasy sample, there is a risk of this grease to remain on the sensor. So to avoid this, we recommend you to prepare a cleaning solution with water and 5% of soap. You will leave this solution on the meter sensor for about 5 minutes, and then with a Q-tip, you will gently clean the surface area, and after you can rinse and dry the sensor before to store it. When it comes to storage, it's important to store the meter dry. I mean, no standard solution, no water on the sensor during the storage. Why? It's very simple, because underneath the pH membrane, we have an internal solution, which is made by KCL. And this solution is diffusing in a sample or in the solution, which is on the sensor. So if you store the meter with water, the internal solution is going to diffuse in the water, and this is going to reduce the lifetime of your electrode. So please store the meter dry, but after storing the meter for a long time, remember the electrode conditioning is critical. And finally, it's important to know that with HORIBA LAQUA twin pH meter, and also most of the pH meter on the market, HORIBA or other brand, is important to understand that the pH electrode is made in glass. So because it's made in glass, it can be fragile. And the LAQUA twin case is a very thin layer of glass. And if you apply a pressure on it, you have a risk of damaging it. So please handle the sensor very carefully. I hope this advice will help you to do a good pH measurement. We have here a link for a presentation of HORIBA LAQUA twin pH meter. Please do not forget to subscribe to our channel and to like this video. I hope to see you soon on another video. Bye bye.